everyone, and welcome back. We continue the prayers, and we will learn today all the rest of Tfilat Shacharit after we covered already the first part of Shacharit. This is the morning blessing, the Korbanot, Psukei Dezimra, the two blessings of Shema Yisrael and Shema Yisrael, and one blessing after Shema Yisrael, and then we did the Amidah. We'll learn about Shmona Esre. We'll learn about the Amidah, the silent prayer that divided by three sections. But the three sections, that the three first brachot, and then the 13 brachot in the middle, that we're asking whatever we want, and then the last three, that this is actually the blessing that we grateful and say thank you to Hashem. And we learn how to bow four times during the Shmona Esre, and we learn how to do three steps when we do Oseh Shalom. Tonight, Bezrat Hashem, would like to continue the rest of Shacharit. We have left only a little bit, whatever left over, and then we're going to learn Bezrat Hashem Mincha, and then we're going to learn Arvit. If you remember this page, we hear. So we cover, Baruch Hashem, all of it. Morning blessings, Psukei Dezimra, and Shema Yisrael, Shmona Esre, Amidah. And then now we get into the point that we're going to learn about Tachanun, which means confession. And then we're going to learn about Ashrei and Uval Etzion. Okay, this is the last part of Shmona Esre that are very, very important. Of course, we have left more than that in the end, that this is a few chapters of Psalm from Tehillim. And then we have Korbanot, the sacrifices, again, before the end of the Tefillah. And then we have the last part of Shacharit, that this is actually the last part of every Tefillah, called Aleinu Leshabeach. Okay, then we're going to learn about Mincha and about Arvit. We should know that every prayer that we're going to learn about, whether it's Mincha, whether it's Arvit, and whether it's Musaf, and whether it's prayers of Shabbat, have the Amidah of Shmona Esre. The only difference is that in Shacharit and Mincha and Arvit, we have the 19 blessing. But when we have Musaf, the prayers that we pray on Shabbat or on Rosh Chodesh or in holidays, it's not building by the 18, 19 blessing. We have only 7. Okay? We're going to learn about it. But the rest of the tefillot, which is Mincha and Arvit, it's the Shmona Esre Amidah, it's all the same. Okay? So first of all, let's go and finish what we have left from the last shiur after we finish the Amidah. We finished the Amidah in the page 168. We did Oseh Shalom Me'umav. We took three steps. By the way, this is the time that you allow to ask whatever you want. Before Yiyu L'Ratzon, you can mark it. You can ask whatever you want. If you didn't do it before, Shomea Tefillah, can ask you whatever you want. And then you finish Shmona Esre, do Oseh Shalom. And then if you want, you can add this additional blessing about Bet HaMikdash, that may Hashem will build Bet HaMikdash in our time as soon as possible. Here, you can see in the Siddur that he says that in Rosh Chodesh, we say Halel. Halel in Rosh Chodesh, or in Chol HaMoed, and Chanukah on page 423. Halel, this is the blessing that we say right after Shmona Esre, right after the repetition of the Chazan, we stop here and we jump into Halel. Halel, it's actually, we're going to learn about it. It's actually a few chapters from Psalm, who praise Hashem, praise God. And we have a blessing of the Halel. This is one of the 7 mitzvot de Rabbanan. One of the 7 mitzvot from the rabbis, not from the Torah. It's to read Halel on Rosh Chodesh. Rosh Chodesh, it's the first month of every month. Sometimes it's the end of the month, Lamed, which means the 30th of the month, and the first of the following month. Like today. Today it's Rosh Chodesh. Rosh Chodesh Tammuz, it's today's Aleph. It's the first of Tammuz. Yesterday also we had Rosh Chodesh. It's the 30th of Sivan. So sometimes it's 2 days Rosh Chodesh, sometimes it's 1 day Rosh Chodesh. Anyway, we have Rosh Chodesh, we have to say the blessing of Halel. And then we have also additional blessing that we say only from Rosh Hashanah until Yom Kippur, the 10 days of Teshuvah. We have the blessing that called Avinu Malkeinu. Avinu Malkeinu is the blessing that we actually say to Hashem to write us in the book of life, write us in the book of Parnasa, book of salvations, and remove all the bad things around us, and to make us a sweet year. We talk about it when we talk about Rosh Hashanah in the Jewish calendar series. And this is part of the tefillah that we say from Rosh Hashanah to Yom Kippur. You can see here what we say, Avinu Malkeinu. Avinu, which means our fathers. Malkeinu, it's our king. Chatanu lefanecha rachem aleinu. We make a sin in front of you, so please have a mercy on us. We have no father, we have no king. Elanu melech elata. You are the only one. Avinu Malkeinu, do it for you, it's your own sake. And make us a good year. And remove all the bad verdict upon us. And all the enemies around us. And so on. You see, our father, our king, renew us a good year. You can see it here. All of it. And then we say, our father, please inscribe us in the book of the good life. Inscribe us in the book of righteous and pious. So all of it, it's Avinu Malkeinu. We say it only in the time of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. Include Rosh Hashanah and include Yom Kippur after every prayer, after Shacharit and after Mincha. From there, we're skipping from there to the next level. What is the next level? It's Vidui. It's confession. You remember when we talk about it in the time of Yom Kippur? We talk about it, how many times we do Vidui. We do it 10 times. The Vidui is actually when we stand in and we say sorry about our Averot, our sin, by the alphabet, by the alphabet. So we have 22 letters. So each letter we mention a different sin. Okay? We have 22 letters from the alphabet, and we have also 5 letters that this is the end of the letters, like Mem Sofit, Nun Sofit, Pei Sofit. So additional Nun, Pei, Tzadik, and Kaf. This is called Man Tzapach. So all together we have 27 type of sin that we're doing it a daily basis. That's what we say sorry to Hashem, and we really regret on those things. So we say it when we're standing, and then we say the part that we mention the 13 midot of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. This is called Vayavor. It's called Yud Gimel Midot of Rachamim. It's 13 Midot of Mercy. When Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, when I'm getting upset, the way how to activate my Midot, to activate my mercy, it's to mention my mercy. Hashem, Hashem. God, God. El Rachum Vechanun. You have mercy on us. And Erech Hapaim. You give us the longest time to do Teshuvah. Rav Chesed is so kindness. Ve'emet is so true. Notzer chesed le'alafim, you keep your promise for thousands of years. Notzer avon v'fesa v'chata v'nakeh, you carry the sin for so long, you don't punish right away. And even the people doing the bad things for you, you don't punish them right away, and you give them the opportunity to do the teshuvah for a long time. Okay, so this is basically 13 midot of rachamim. We're doing it every day, except those days that are happiest days. What is the happiest days that we don't do Tachanun on Rosh Chodesh? It's the first day of the month. It's a good day. Also, on the holidays, Chanukah, Purim, Rosh Hashanah, Tu Bishvat, Purim, Shavuot, Passover, Chol HaMoed. Also, if we have a brit in the shul, also if we have a wedding or chatan, pray with us, we don't do it. And whatever, any kind of happiness occasion, we don't do tachanun. Because if somebody else happy, it makes everybody happy, and then there's no, we don't have to mention our sin. So we don't do tachanun. But if we don't have it in the regular days, we do tachanun. Only 1 month in the year, we don't do tachanun the entire month. From Rosh Chodesh Nisan to the end of Nisan. This is the month that we came out from Egypt. It's all happiest month. Okay? The same thing from Rosh Chodesh Sivan until the 12th of Sivan. We don't do Tachanut for 12 days. Okay? And all the days of Hanukkah and the rest of the holidays, it's only for a period of time. But the only month that we don't do the entire month, it's the Chodesh Nisan. Similar to that, Chodesh Tishrei, we have so much holidays. So from Yom Kippur, because we did so much Tachanun in Yom Kippur, we did so much confession, we asked so many times, from Yom Kippur, from the 11th of Yom Kippur until the end of Tishrei, the 11th of Tishrei, until the end of Tishrei, we don't do Tachanun for 3 weeks. Okay? This is the whole, almost the whole entire month of Tishrei, we don't do Tachanun. Other than that, during the year, we do Tachanun every day. And in the morning, also in Mincha, after Shmonasra, after Amidah, and also before we go to sleep. Why? Because we did so much, and we would like to have our neshama. Remember, we talk about it. Our neshama goes up to give the report, to give the report about all what we have done. So that's why we say it before we go to sleep. And not only that we say it. If you say it, your neshama goes very, very high and get the right energy to wake up in the morning and a full energized. If not, sometimes you wake up very tired or it doesn't have enough energy. So anyway, in the morning after Amidah, we do Tachanun. In the first part, we do it like that. We hold in our fist the right hand and we hit our heart in the left. Because our heart causes all our temptations, our desires. Then we mention the 13 midot of Rachamim, and then we do the part that we sit in. It's called Nefilat Apayim. According to Ashkenazim, they hold their hand like that, the left hand, and then they're going on the table like that. When they do Nefilat Apayim, when they do this part, it's part of David HaMelech, the King David, how we say sorry to Hashem. And the Sephardic, we don't do it like that. We don't put our hand. We sit in as a regular and we say this chapter of Tehillim. And part of it is mix of psukim about the confession, about the regrets that we say sorry to Hashem. After that, in the days of Monday on Thursday, we have a different tachanun. It's additional tachanun. It's additional parts that we say sorry so deep about Am Israel, about so many things that we have passed in the history, all those leaders that we have lost, all the Beit HaMikdash that we don't have because of our sin. So only on Monday and Thursday we have the longest vidui, longest tachanun. Okay? After that we're doing the Kaddish, and then we're reading the Torah. We have the blessing of the Torah. You can see it in your Chumash. You can see the vidui, it's page 175. 175. And then you can skip. You can skip. It's the long vidui. You can see 185, 190, until 210. It's the last 20 pages over there. It's about the Monday and Thursday. You can see in the Sidur. And the 210, you see the blessing of the Torah. When we're taking out the Sefer Torah, also only on Monday, on Thursday, of course, on Shabbat. Why? Because we're not allowed to have 3 days without Torah. This is one of the takanot, the establishment that Ezra Sofer, the head of the 120 rabbis of assembly, אנשי כנסת הגדולה, he was the head, and he said that we should have the reading of the Torah every 3 days. So Monday, Thursday, and on Shabbat. What we reading on Monday or Thursday? Only the first Aliyah, the first part of the Parsha, the portion that we reading on Shabbat. So on Monday, we read the first one, and on Thursday, we read the first one. Okay? How many people get in Aliyah la Torah? How many people get in Aliyah to read the Torah? I mean, the rabbi on the Chazan read the Torah. But who can get Aliyah? Only three people. On Monday, on Thursday, only three people getting Aliyah. Getting to get to the Sefer Torah, to say the blessing. You remember the blessing? In the end of the morning blessing, we have in the end of the in the morning blessing, we have the blessing of the Torah. So the same blessing in the end, אשר בחר בנו מכל העמים, ברוך אתה השם אלוקינו מלך העולם, אשר בחר בנו מכל העמים ונתן לנו את תורתו, שם, thank you that you choose us from all the nations, ברוך אתה השם נותן התורה. This is the blessing that you say when you get to Aliyah לתורה. Okay? Three people on Monday and Thursday. On Rosh Chodesh, when we read the Torah on Rosh Chodesh, we're taking out the Sefer Torah, we read a different parasha. We read parasha of Rosh Chodesh. What is the parasha? It's the parasha of the sacrifices that they used to sacrifice on Rosh Chodesh once a month in Beit HaMikdash. So we read it. It's in Sefer Bamidbar, in Parashat Pinchas. So we have this portion of the Torah that is specially for Rosh Chodesh. So we, again, Monday or Thursday, we have three people getting Aliyah LaTorah. On Rosh Chodesh, we have four people. Okay? On Yom Tov, on holidays, when we take out the Sefer Torah in Passover, in Pesach, and Sukkot, or Shavuot, or either Rosh Hashanah, or even on Rosh Hashanah, yeah, we have five people getting Aliyah. Five people. Sukkot, Shavuot, and Passover, and Rosh Hashanah. On Yom Kippur, we elevate more. We have six people. Yom Kippur, we have six people getting Aliyah LaTorah. On Shabbat, we have seven people. Shabbat, people doesn't know it. Shabbat, the highest level, more than Yom Kippur, even more than anything. People say, you know what, I'm keeping only Yom Kippur, but Shabbat, I don't keep. No, it's much more important. You see, the seven people getting Aliyah LaTorah on Shabbat. We have seven Aliyot. That's what the parasha divided by seven parts. Okay? So Monday and Thursday, three people. Rosh Chodesh, four. Yom Tov, holidays, it's five. Yom Kippur, it's six. Shabbat, it's seven. Okay? But in the regular days, as Monday and Thursday, we're reading only three people getting Aliyah. The rest of the days of the week, we don't take out the Sefer Torah. Okay? And Shabbat, it's something else. We have seven people and reading the entire parasha. After we finish the blessing of the Torah or the reading of the Torah, and after we open the ark and we take out the Sefer Torah, we put it back, okay? We close the ark of the Sefer Torah and we continue the last part of Shacharit. What is the last part of Shacharit? It's called Ashrei Yoshvei Beitecha. You remember what I said when we learn about Pesukei Dezimra? Ashrei. It's a chapter 145. It's the best and the highest and the important chapter of Tehillim, of Psalm. Why? Because we have, first of all, it goes by the alphabet, by the alphabet. Also, Hashem said over there that He's taking care of the Parnasa, all the creatures of the world. So we have the Pasuk Potech et Yadecha. We have the Pasuk that open your hands, and Hashem will fulfill your will. Right? So if you say it three times a day, you get in the ticket to Olam Haba, you remember? So the first time we say it in the Pesukei Dezimra, and now we say it in the end of Tefillat Shacharit again. Okay? So we say Ashrei Yoshvei Beitecha in the page 214. You can go, when we finish the 214, you see another chapter of Tehillim that call Lamnatzeach Mizmor Le David Yancha Adonai Beyom Tzara. Okay? What is the Yom Tzara? It's the chapter 20 in Tehillim, in Psalm, talks about that Hashem will answer you in your problems day. In the day of that you got troubles, Hashem will answer you. And this is chapter 20 in Psalm. So we said also only on the regular days. If we have the happiest days, like holidays, Chol HaMoed, or any kind, even Rosh Chodesh, we skip it. We don't want to mention a trouble in the happiest day. 214, it started in Ashrei. Then we have the Lamnatzeach Mizmor David and Chashe B'Yom Tzara. We have the last part that this is called Uva Letzion. Uva Letzion. This is the last part that I mentioned here, Uva Letzion, that this is talks about that combination of few psukim together, but we have the Kedusha over there. When I ask you what is the Kedusha, when we say Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh. So the first time we say it in the first blessing before Shema Yisrael, that the angels do Kadosh, 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 and we join them. The second one, what is that? What is the second one? When the Chazan do the repetition, we do Kedusha. That's what I ask you. Someone wrote, it's the holiness. No, Kedusha, it's the part that we're doing in the repetition after the Gevurot, after the Mechaya Metim. We all standing and we're jumping three times when we mention the word Kadosh, 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 Holy, Holy, Holy. So this is the second time. The third time we do Kadosh, 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 when we do Uva Letzion, and also we mention Kadosh, 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 that's very important to say it. When we finish Uva Letzion, we have few chapters from Tehillim that it's not necessary to say it. It's part of the Shacharit. I mean, if you have time, of course, you can say it. Tfilah Le'aniki Atof, it's part of the Tehillim. And then we have Shir HaMaalot, from Tehillim, and then we have Bet Yaakov Nelchu Melecha Beor Adonai, and then we have after that the Shir Shel Yom. Shir Shel Yom, it's the song of the day. The song of the day, it's basically, it's the song that the Leviim, those who used to sing in Bet HaMikdash, those, because we have Kohanim, who used to serve in Bet HaMikdash and make the sacrifices, and sacrifice the sacrifice for the Israeli people. And the Leviim, it comes from Moshe Rabbeinu, come from the tribe of Levi. We have 12 tribes. So the second one is Levi. Aaron become Kohen Gadol. And from Moshe Rabbeinu, the Leviim come. Okay? So the Leviim used to sing all the songs. So each day have a different songs. It's basically chapters of Psalm. So each day you can see a different song that belongs to this day. And then the last part, it's the part of Korbanot. This is the part that we're going back to the world of the Bria. The part of Korbanot, it's the sacrifices. Like we did it before Shacharit, we did the Korbanot sacrifices. Also, we end Tfilat Shacharit by doing Korbanot. And then we finish Tfilat Shacharit. The Chazan say, Baruchu et Adonai, Yam Vorach, bless Hashem, that Hashem is blessed. And then everybody answer, Baruch Adonai, Yam Vorach, Leolam Vaed. Okay? And then we do the last part. It's called Aleinu Leshabeach. You can see it. Aleinu Leshabeach, it's the blessing that Yehoshua bin Nun, the student of Moshe Rabbeinu, he established and he wrote this blessing. It's basically said that we should have said thank you to Hashem and be grateful that Hashem chooses from all the nation and makes us a different from all the nations on the world, that they're a bow to a different world, to a different gods, a different high powers, a different statue. And we bow to Hashem. So when we mention the word, we bow to Hashem, to God, אנחנו משתחווים לפני מלך מלכי המלכים, we bow in front of the greatest and the biggest king of the world, we need to bow a little bit, and then we finish the second part, al kenekave lach. This is the second part of Alel Shabbach. It says start with the letter Ein and end with the letter Daled, which means Ed, witness. And the second part also start with the letter Ein, end with the letter Daled, Ed, which means Ein Daled, another witness. Ed in Hebrew, it's a witness. So this is two witnesses that you finish Shacharit. So if you don't have time for all the other parts from Amidah until then, so you can finish 18, do Ashrosh Bebetecha and skip to Alelu Shabbat. If you don't have time, so finish Amidah and then do Alelu Shabbat right away. So this is the end of the Tefillah, of every prayer, not just for Shacharit, every prayer. Okay? And then afterwards, we continue the prayer of Mincha. After we finish Shacharit, Baruch Hashem. When we finish Shacharit, we take off the tefillin. If you're a man, you're taking off the tefillin. First of all, you're opening the part of your hand, and then you take it off the tefillin of your head. You put it in the box, you fold it, and then you take it off the tefillin of your arms. You put it in the box, you fold it, and then you take it off the tzitzit, the talit, you fold it, you finish Shacharit, and you can start the day. When we coming back after noon, we have the Tfilat Mincha. What is the time Tfilat Mincha? Who is the one who established Tfilat Mincha? As you know, we said that Avraham Avinu established Tfilat Shacharit, the prayer of Shacharit. He woke up in the morning, Vashkem Avraham Baboker, the Gemara in Brachot, page 26, Kafav, the Gemara said Avraham established Tfilat Shacharit. Yitzchak, his son, he established Tfilat Mincha. When he established Tfilat Mincha, when the Pasuk said, Vayetze Yitzchak Lasuach Basadeh, when Rivka, his future wife, came with Eliezer, he was the servant of his father, the servant of Avraham. He used to look for a shiduch, for a girl, for zivug, for Yitzchak. When they came back together, they saw that Yitzchak is praying outside. So the Gemara said, what is the prayer that he pray? He established Tfilat Mincha. And Yaakov, the son of Yitzchak, he established Tfilat Arvit. But you remember, when we say established, which means that they established the time of Tfilah. But they didn't have a specific words until the 120 rabbis of assembly, the Anshei Knesset Agdula, write it down on the Siddur, because everybody forget and everybody didn't know what exactly to do. Okay? So when Avraham established the Shacharit and Yitzchak established Tfilat Mincha, this is the time to pray Mincha. What is the earliest time to pray Mincha? Right after Chatzot and a half. Chatzot, it's like 12:30. Or sometimes in the summer it's 1 or 1:15. So you're taking another half an hour. So 1:30 or 1:45, this is the earliest time you're allowed to pray Mincha. Okay? And you have enough time until the sunset. Some of the people pray Mincha early at 2 o'clock. It's called Mincha Gdola, when the day is big. That's why it's called a big Mincha. So most of the people pray Mincha Ktana in the end of the day, because they want to do it with Arvit together, Mincha and Arvit together. When is that? Before the sunset. So we started a little bit before the sunset, and we'll finish before the sunset. And sometimes it goes after the sunset. If you didn't have enough time, if you can't make it, or you see that it's the sunset, it's over already, you still have enough time, which is 13 and a half minutes. This is called Ben Hashmashot, between the sunrise, which means that we have the sunrise, but after the sunrise, you see that it's still light outside. So it takes some time until the sun goes. So it's called Ben Hashmashot. So it still have time to pray Mincha. Okay? So it's better to do it and it's the right time to do it before sunset. But if you didn't make it, you still have 13 and a half minutes to pray mincha. And then it's over, and then it's the time of arvit. If you miss mincha, you need to do arvit twice, two times to do amida. What is tefillat mincha? Tefillat mincha, basically, it's the prayer that start with the chapter of Tehillim lamnatzeach al hagidid lekoach mizmor. Okay? We have chapter of Tehillim, and then we have korbanot. We starting with the chapter of Tehillim, and then we have few parts that we mentioned, the sacrifices. Then we start Ashrosh v'Betecha. According to the Ashkenazim, they start right away Ashrosh v'Betecha. Ashrosh v'Betecha, Odeh Aluch, Hasela. Okay? This is actually the third time of the day that we mention Ashrosh v'Betecha. Why we say Ashrosh v'Betecha three times? Because we need to say it three times a day. We'll get a ticket to Olam Habay if we mention it three times. So this is the third time. Okay? So Ashkenazim start right away Ashrosh v'Betecha. The Sephardim start from the beginning, which is the page you can see in the Sidur Levi Eliezer, 270, you can see it, we start in Tefillat Mincha. We have Amida as the same. You remember? We have Amida, you're starting the Tefillat Amida, Tefillat Shmona Esre, taking three steps back, three steps forward, you're starting Adonai Svatai Tiftach Ufi Hagit Eladecha, you bow, Baruch Atah Awanai, starting all the Amida, as we learn. And then you finish, you do Oseh Shalom Merumah, Uvachah Oseh Shalom Alel, and Kol Omo Yisrael V'Imu Amen, taking three steps back. Then you have, again, the same pattern that we have in Shacharit. If we have Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, you mention Avinu Malkenu. Otherwise, you continue to Vidui. You're doing Vidui again. Ashanu, Bagadnu, Gazanu, all the Vidui. And then you mention the 13 midot of rachamim, and then you sit down, you do nefilat apayim. If you're Ashkenazi, you do like that. If you're Sephardic, you read it as a regular. Then you finish tefillat mincha by saying the chapter of Tehillim. It's called Lamnatzeach bin Ginot Mizmor Shir. This is the menorah chapter. Menorah chapter. Some of the people read it from a specific page that wrote in the shape of the menorah. That very, very, it's a lot of sgulot to look at it. If you read it from this page of klaf, a real klaf, real page from like Sefer Torah, it's sgula to have success in the day, or to have a light, or if you have a very important meeting, you can read it in the menorah. But anyway, so we do Lam Natzach Ben Ginot Ben Morshir, then we do Kaddish, and then we do Aleinu Leshabeach as we finish every prayer. Shacharit, Mincha, and Arvit, or any kind of prayer, even Musaf or Neila, we have Aleinu Leshabeach. This is the last part of every tefillah. And then we finish Mincha. Finish Mincha, we start in Arvit. How we start in Arvit? We start in with three psukim. Arvit, it's the page 346. 346, we start in by saying, Adonai Tzvaot Imanu Misgav Leanu Yaakov Sela, Adonai Tzvaot Asher Adamotei Arbach, Adonai Yoshiya HaMelech Ya'anenu Bemkorenu. Three psukim, and then we say Kaddish. The Chazan say Kaddish, Itgadal Itgadash Shmei Rabbah. It's a half of Kaddish. And then we have another psukim. Ve'u Rachum Yechaper Avon, Ve'lo Yashchit, Ve'rba Lashiv Apo, Lo Ye'er Kol Chamato, Adonai Yoshiya HaMelech Ya'anenu Bemkorenu. This is three psukim. And then we start in the two blessings before Kriyat Shema. But before we start in the two blessings before Kriyat Shema, we have to say Baruchu. Again, the Chazan mentioned Baruchu, Et Amonai Yam Vorach, bless Hashem. Everybody bow a little bit and say Baruch Adonai Yam Vorach L'Olam Va'ed. Then we start in the two blessings before Arvit. It's very similar, the two blessings before Shema Yisrael in Arvit, to the two blessings before Shema Yisrael in Shacharit. Because the first one in Arvit, it's called Ama'ariv Aravim. We started Baruch Atah Hashem Elokeinu Melech HaOlam Asher Bidvaro Ma'ariv Aravim HaChokhmah. Hashem have the knowledge, the wisdom to turn the lights and the darkness in the right time. Talk about all the stars and the creation. It's the same thing like in Shacharit, or we talk about Yotzer HaMeorot, that we talk about the moon and the sun and all the creation that Hashem created in the world. The second blessing, after we finish Baruch Ata Onai, HaMa'ariv HaRavim, we start the second blessing, we start Ahavat Olam, Ahavtanu. Ahavat Olam, this, according to Ashkenazim, it's Ahava Rabba, according to Sfaradim, it's Ahavat Olam. It's a blessing about how Hashem loves us, how Hashem cares about us, how we would like to connect to Hashem through the Torah, through the mitzvot. And Hashem loves us so much, we end in the blessing by Baruch Atah Hashem Ohev Amo Yisrael. It's the same thing like we in Shacharit, we have Ahavat Olam, the same thing. And then we say Shema Yisrael, right in the right hand, we say Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Okay, you remember? Echad, remember Aleph, Chet, and Daled, four directions in the sky, and all the seven levels in the sky, and our earth, and Hashem is Echad. Hashem is only one. Reading the three chapters of Shema Yisrael, Ve'afta, Ve'ayam Shamoa, Ve'yomer, talks about Tzitzit. Then we have two blessings after that. In Shacharit, we have only one blessing after Shema Yisrael. In Arvit, we have two blessings after Shema Yisrael. What is the first one? It's called Ve'emunah Kol Zot. Talks about how much we need to believe in Hashem after He did so much miracles to us and how much Hashem took us out from Egypt. Ve'emunah Kol Zot Zekam Alelu Ki Adonai Elu Ve'en Zot Manach Misal Amo Apodenu Miyad Melechim. Hashem took us out from Egypt. He opened the ocean for us. And Hashem did so much for us. Baruch Atah Hashem Ga'al Yisrael. We're talking about the future redemption that Hashem, and also the past redemption, and Hashem redeem us from Egypt, and Hashem will redeem us, Bezrat Hashem, the next redemption. And then we have the last blessing before Amidah. This is the second blessing after Shema Yisrael. It's called Hashkivenu. We stand in, on Shabbat we stand in, on a regular day we sitting down, and we say, Hashkivenu, Avinu Leshalom. Hashem, please help us to sleep in the quiet, in a calm, and remove all the bad things around us, all the evil, all the demons, all the enemies, all the death, all the problems around us, remove from us. Hashem alenu makat oyev, dev, cherev, choli, tzara, ra'a, ra'a, ve'yagon, hunger, all the problems, Baruch Atah Hashem. We finish the blessing by saying, Baruch Atah Adonai, Shomer et Amo Yisrael la'ad, Amen. Hashem, you keep and protect Am Yisrael forever. This is the last blessing. We finish this second blessing. Then we say Kaddish. The Chazan say Kaddish. If we don't pray in Minyan, in the Shul, you don't need to say Kaddish. You're starting right away Amidah. Again, starting Amidah, three steps backward, three steps forward, starting Amidah. You finish 18, and that's it. After 18, we say, again, Kaddish. Then we have the chapter of Tehillim. This is the chapter of Tehillim 121. It's Shir Lama'alot Esayinai Le'arim. That we raise, I raise my eyes to the mountains. That my help will come. Only from Hashem, my salvation will come. Very special Shir LaMa'alot, Yaakov Avinu say it, when he ran away from Lavan, from Esav, from his brother, when he looked for Zivug. It's also very Sgula to get Shiduch, when you say this Shir LaMa'alot Esayinai, it's seven verses, seven psukim. It's a psalm, on Psalm chapter 121. We finish it, and then we say Baruchu. Again, the Chazan say Baruchu. Everybody answer after him. Baruchu Adonai Avroach, Baruch Adonai Elohim Avroach Olam Ve'ed. Then we do Aleinu Nesabeach. So we do Aleinu Nesabeach of every single prayer in the end. Odei Shacharit, Mincha, and Arvit. We do Aleinu Nesabeach, we finish Arvit. When we finish Arvit, that's it. We actually finish the prayer of the day. Okay? One more thing before you go to sleep. Before we go to sleep, again, we need to say Shema Yisrael. So you say Shema Yisrael if you would like to to say the short one, you can say the short one, but it's better to do the whole three parts. And then in the end, also we're doing tachanun before you go to sleep. You want to make sure that you clean yourself, because you know nobody knows you're going to wake up tomorrow. So before you go to sleep, it's very, very also to make you sleep and calm and relax. So keep your neshama, say Shema Yisrael before you go to sleep. But other than that, you finish Shema Yisrael. If you're a woman, you can choose one of the tefillot, either Shacharit, either Mincha, and either Arvit. Mincha and Arvit are very, very short. It's just Ashrei and Shmona Esrei. In Arvit, it's just Shema Yisrael and Shmona Esrei. So you can choose whatever you want. B'zod Hashem, see you next time.